Good morning, students. Yesterday we have talked about kinds of sentences, and we have been learning of two sentences, those were declarative sentences and the imperative sentences. So our declarative and imperative sentences already over. We have already talked about yesterday. For today's learning, or today we will talk about interrogative sentence and exclamatory sentence. Alright? So, for today's learning, we will start from our interrogative sentence. Interrogative sentence is used to ask a question. When we are asking someone, or someone is asking us, in which tone or in which manner they are asking, that is known as our interrogative sentence. If we are asking them, then it is our interrogative speech. That is language when we are speaking. When we are writing the question sentence, that is our interrogative sentence. So, interrogative sentence is here. The next name for interrogative sentence is question sentence. Alright? Question sentence. In this what we used to do? We are asking question, or someone is asking question from us. Means this is the way when someone is asking a question. In a nutshell, we can say that interrogative sentence is used to ask a question. Clear? Now we have one example is given. Have you taken your meal? Now you have to listen carefully, and you have to think, and you have to hear the tone. Have you taken your meal? Means someone is asking you, isn't it? And at the end we have our question mark. When we are starting our sentence, that is our word. That is no subject over there. Have is our verb, and then it is followed by the subject, and then at the end of the sentence we have a put a question mark. If we not give a question mark, then that sentence will not be called an interrogative sentence or our question sentence. Clear? So declarative is over, imperative is over. We have started from interrogative today. An interrogative sentence is used when we are asking a question, or interrogative sentence or question sentence is used to ask a question. Alright? Now we will step into sentence number 4. Not sentence number 4, that is point number 4. It is our exclamatory sentence. That is point number 4. It is our kinds of sentences. Point number 4, exclamatory sentence. This we will learn. Exclamatory sentence is used to express emotions, express our feelings, such as happy. Happy. When we are happy, we are showing our feelings to others, isn't it? When we are sad, that time also our facial expression is something different, isn't it? So sad. When you are getting hurt, that time you have some pain. And when we are enjoying, that time you feel joy. All these are the feelings. They are not the things that you can carry and show to anyone. It is just our emotions, our feelings, and according to the noun, it is our abstract noun. Alright? So, for exclamation, some words are there: happy, sad, pain, and joy. For the exclamatory sentence, again you have to remember that some extraordinary sentences there. And what you have to remember that I am telling you. Example. Example, what a wonderful scene. After seeing there is no full stop, no question mark, then what, which type of mark we have to put there? Exclamation mark. If you see any sentence with the ending of an exclamation mark, that type of sentence is called your exclamatory sentence. And in those types of sentences, we are expressing our emotions or feelings to others. Alright? So, these type of sentences are known as our exclamatory sentence. So, students, according to kinds of sentences, declarative sentence we have finished yesterday. And with that we have got imperative sentence. Today we talked about interrogative sentence, and with that one more sentence is there, exclamatory sentence. So altogether four we got, isn't it? So I want to see you all whether you have followed the whole lesson or not. I'll give you a small work. You have to finish that work and you have to send those work, whatever work I'm giving you, you have to finish it and send it to me in the PDFs. So here we have ended exclamatory sentence. No. Now the work I'm giving you. Some sentence you might have been seeing here. Sentence number A, sentence number B. This I will solve for you as an example. Then the solution you have to make by your own. Okay? Here in number 8 is given, she is clever. At the end there is full stop. Now we have to convert this sentence into question sentence. Then what we'll do? She is clever. You have to shift the verb and give its place at the beginning of the sentence. Shift this verb and bring it in the starting of the sentence. So here we will get is, and after that whatever the subject is there, subject after the verb, subject will go, and then the remaining verbs. Clever. After clever, no full stop. There should be question mark. Clear? Like that. Number B. The sentence is given. We are late. Then, how will change it? How will make question sentence? Are we late? The verb will start. The sentence is the verb. Are we late? And then question mark. So students, you not have to bring any word from outside. All the words are given in the same sentence. Only you have to change their places. Alright? See. She is clever. Is this here? She is also here. Clever is here. All the words are given. In our second sentence also all the words are there only. But only the places we have changed. Clear? Maybe some problem you will have. For that also I am telling you. Here is all right. The same everything is here. We have where. Where is our verb? From where we will start our verb. And we have to state the words. And yesterday I had told you. The meaning of sentence. You have to keep on carrying the words. And keep setting those words according to its place. That you can get a meaning. Alright. Anyhow, you try to solve these sentences. I have given you as your prayer. So, here I have given exercises to solve. Convert these questions, convert into question sentences. Convert all these sentences into question sentences. All the sentences, whatever I have written on the board, all those are sentences. And all those we have to change into question sentences. Now you have to solve all these questions as your prayer and send the answers to me and in the PDFs I have given my contact number. Alright, in that you can send it, and from there only I can know whether you have followed the whole lesson or not. If any incorrect sentence is there, we'll try to solve it. Alright, so our lesson 15 is over today. So students, till then keep on learning. Take care. Thank you.